we have Lizzie and Greg from Connecticut who have come down to drop off their black hole pinball machine. They're going to have me go over it. And
we need a new table, that's why, right?
Oh, we're just going to put stuff on top of it and ignore it for 5 months.
We'll come back for it eventually.
Don't spit on me.
No, we're going to work on it. I'm going to bang him for this one. I am going to make them sorry they ever dropped it off.
Wait, hold on. Have you seen our other pinballs in here? Hold on.
Oh, God.
That's what it's going to end up looking like.
It's a work table. It's a work in progress. I don't know.
Piles of stuff all over them.
Well, I don't know what to do with this. The guy, he's in the hospital. He's been there for 6 months, and I don't know what to do. Now you made me depressed, Jonathan. But in front of Lizzie and Greg and my brother, I want to show you something that I think maybe end up being fun. Jim from Ohio has sent me a special gift, and I'm wondering. We already had this check. Somebody listened to it, not ticking. It's somebody not made sure it wasn't anthrax.
He said coffee.
And it's on graph paper. That means he is probably in math. He loves math. Hi, Todd. I'm Jim, an artist from Ohio. I enjoy, artists use graph paper. I enjoy watching your videos when I work. They helped the time pass. I didn't see that right. Much quicker. I've painted a portrait of you in the style of Hitchcock.
That should be great.
Thanks again for the hours and hours of entertainment. They love me. Jonathan, has anybody ever painted a portrait of you?
Nope.
That's not true.
Get your barf bags ready.
Wait a minute. Hitchcock is fat.
You painted when you were seven.
And ugly. Oh! Fat, bald, and ugly.
Who said that?
Well, that's what Hitchcock is. Oh, no. That sounds like it's in the style of me already.
Oh, I can't wait to see this.
Oh, that's great.
That's the Adams family. This is Alfred Hitchcock. You get your theme song.
Here, do it. Stay next to it.
Wait a minute.
Perfect. That's an original, y'all.
It is.
I know where it could go. Right up here.
Actually, that's exactly right here. Right there. Right there. I sold the Firefox. There it is.
That's awesome.
Thanks, Jim. What do you think?
That's wonderful.
First reaction. You're in your dumpster.
I got a barf bag for you guys.
Does it?
That one had more hair.
Oh,
that's pretty cool.
Better likeness.
I like that.
Very cool.
Did you notice I added the music?
I couldn't resist.
It's now in the showroom hall of fame.
Thank you very much, Jim. That was quite the gift. Now I'm gonna give them a bill for that black hole they'll never forget.
$50, right?
That's just for the invoice.
For the piece of paper.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I've been holding
this. These are three color. We bought the invoices where you have to have like a really heavy hand for it to even make a copy through the second copy. They were cheaper.
Of course.
Let's move on into the back. You've been waiting. Hear the music. Although the music's not from the game, it's from the Disney Atlantis, but I thought it was perfect for a very rarely seen game. They only made 1,501. Now, what was that decision? Let's make some Atlantises. Rather than 1,500, 1,300, 1,400, let's make 1,501. But this is a special one because the man that sent it to us for reconditioning, he was missing the submarine. Now, do you see this? This is a toy submarine we bought on eBay. And we had to do a lot of retrofitting and repainting because it was some garish color to make it fit. Now, obviously our customer can take and do what he'd like with the arms. The arms are on it. The little searchlights are on it. See, they just snap on. And we're not sure how durable they'll be. If they get hit by the ball, we don't know. But the customer can decide. Now, the game also came with these little guys here, the submarine kit. So we have them Velcroed on there, so he can take them off. He made it pretty clear he didn't like them already. So off they come. But if you've been watching our videos, you know that we had an issue with this game because the numbers were missing off of the edges. See, the factory Mylar was intact and everything was fine, except on the sides, the numbers and the letters were gone. Here, and especially up here, this was completely missing. It was just bare wood. And our Steven has repainted it, and we got a whole new decal set, courtesy of Classic Arcade. I have a video. Let me show you.
All right, Bobby, you can start filming. Not that. Over here.
Look what he's sucking. Yeah, it's big and juicy. Yeah. Butterscotch. We're Mark in California.
Coffee.
Butterscotch.
Chocolate
coffee.
Coffee's good. I love coffee.
Boss, where's your sucker?
Oh, he's not here right now.
Oh! He said he's... Oh, and what's your flavor?
Butterscotch.
I'm butterscotch, too.
Coffee.
I'm chocolate.
First,
sexual chocolate.
I like my lollipops. I like my...
Oh, you're dirty
First,
boy.
This is Atlantis. Now, let me show you what we discovered on the lake.
Looks a mess.
Send it in for an overhaul. Look at this. Crud-o-matic. Now, here's good news. The good news is it's got the factory Mylar on it, which is really good. The bad news is the factory Mylar did not go up here. Now, I have good news. I have really good news for you. Turn the camera up to show me the good news. Here. Not that close. Back a little. Thank you. I commissioned Jeff at Classic Arcades to make his very first set of decals. Complete set of decals. Everything. Now, I don't need everything. But you may on your Atlantis. But he's going to make. See, these are missing. This is missing. This is missing. Okay? All these are missing. Okay. Now, when you have, this is important to know because Joe Zabo made custom side art for the Tempest for someone. These guys will make custom stuff for you, the first set. But you have to pay for the time it takes. So Jeff charged me $110 for the first set because he spent, I think, 3 hours getting it right. But now, you can order the decal set for a lot less from him because now it's done. I have no problem. Nobody should have any problem paying for a setup. When Joe did the Blackwater 100 art for me, we paid extra. The man who wanted this art, he paid extra. And now Joe has it on his website, so you can buy it cheap. Much cheaper. Not cheap, but much cheaper. The same is true with the Tempest Cabaret. And now the same is true with Jeff. These men will make custom art for you, okay? But you have to pay for the initial work. My Route 16, perfectly good example, my video game. Joe made that beautiful, gorgeous marquee for me. It made me very happy, and I had no problem paying him $100 and some to get the initial art, and now you can buy a marquee from him for $45 or $50. Great. Good deal, guys. Anyway, so this is a work in progress. And there's also missing the submarine. So we came up with this great idea that I think is pretty neat. So
Now what game is this, Todd?
These are good.
Yeah, these are.
See's candy.
What game is this?
This is a Spy Hunter. I had to give it some thought.
Got a button.
This comes off in a sheet, just like that Asteroids. Peels off, just like that.
So Steven's getting it ready for what, side art?
Side art. Steven has the side art up front. We're flattening it out, and it'll be as flat as this man's head.
How about the bald spot up in your head?
I'm worse. I can't see it. And he's that's only 30.
That's custom right there.
Yeah. Actually, you're not
this
30.
This one he's been brewing for a
he's
while.
He's 40. He's 40. Jesus.
Doesn't look a day over 39.
Boing. Hey, you didn't see it, but I did it. Wasn't that nice? Look at that. And look, even stickers for the drop targets, the seahorse stickers to make the target set complete. Now, we got the first video off. We sent a video to the fella to show him what we were doing with it. We have the submarine is lit with a multicolor color changer, okay. We also lit the bottom here with blue. The nice effect, our customer asked us to change this to a green, which we did. It came with an orange one, so we switched it with a green one. But then he said, the colors don't match. I said, what do you mean? What are you talking about? He says, well, the red, the white, and the yellow targets were correct here. But he said, they're not correct over here. Well, after we looked at it, we figured it was a factory error. The picture on the left shows how the game came in. Red was right on the top, but the 2 and 3 colors are reversed. Yellow is in the middle and white on the bottom. Look on the right, that's what we changed it to. What we did is we cut away the factory Mylar, we popped the 2 jewels out, scraped the numbers off using Jeff's new numbers, we put them back in, and boom. Fixed. 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 Look at this. Look at all the things that we did to this. Well, first of all, we've lit the submarine with a color changer. And as you saw, we added these things. We lit blue in the back here. Isn't that nice? Now, he also, instead of having all one solid color, he did different colors. We have green, yellow, the red, the blue here. Okay, and same at the top. But when you go underwater, when you dive, the whole top of the playfield turns red, as you're gonna see. It's really nice. And look, see, our new stickers here, courtesy of that same sticker set. And there's quite a difference. Let me show you the difference. Look up top, okay? And look at how it used to look. Yes. Wow, what a difference. See what a little magic a TNT shop does? Well, anyway, let me show you back here. We have the same color layout. This is what the customer wanted. He said, please do the exact same layout you did on the other video. Guess what? The other video, 3 years ago, a little over 3 years ago, there's the link to it. Because that's going to show extensive gameplay if you want to see it. We're going to play a little bit, but you can watch that and I'll show you all the rules. But this game here, we've rebuilt the power supply. Frank beefed it up. We put heavier diodes in there, new capacitors, Frank's button battery board up here, and the customer can change the board at will. And of course, all the boards were reheated. All the care we take on these machines, as much as we can do, you know, to make it as perfect as we can, isn't it? It's near perfect.
Diver, get up.
Okay, Frank, let's see what we can get. I was about to die there. Okay, now look. 1-1-1.
Load it and lock.
Drop star ramp.
Down airlock. 1.
That beautiful, gorgeous effect. Now in this game, remember you want to roll through a lane that's lit. Okay, and that advances your top here. See, making A and B will advance there. So we want to get two next.
Load and lock.
That's level three.
Not hard enough.
Lock down, airlock.
Now, the targets here in the center progress these up here, okay? Now, on Atlantis, I did notice one thing, and everybody that owns Atlantis, if your balls are not rolling through, make sure you're level. I can see this is a little off level, but we don't have it on legs. So you gotta make sure the game is perfectly level. And then the balls will fire out beautifully. We have this easy to take off too, using the same screw or squeeze methods to take them out. So the man getting this will be able to take it apart easily if he has to service that. Isn't that a beautiful light show? Did right down the toilet, didn't we? So this unsnaps, this top comes off, and then you squeeze the hub to lift the ship off. Exactly the same way we're using the same clips as the original game. Now, what do you think, folks? Pretty nice. And we also let down here, so I'm not sure if we pointed that out. I think we did. And here we go. Now we got our lights hold bonus. Our guy comes up here, and there's our bonus collect. Collected the bold hold bonus. Well, that's it. Loading. It came out nice. Stephen painted the red. Do you see that? We added our famous light-o-matic buttons on the side. We'll be the first people doing that now. Everybody else stole it from us. Now you weren't. Anyway, wanted to share some other stuff. You know my signature picture with me and the cigarette holder? One of our fans in Germany, Metal, decided to do the same thing, except with his pipe. Pretty gracious. And he's got me on three screens, Frank. But you know what? I think it's time we go and look at that Super Zaxxon we had forever on the bargain basement until we found this sucker, this buyer that came and took it off our hands. Let's see that. Look what we have for Gerald. A bargain basement. We're trying to unload this piece of crap.
This gold. This
piece of gold. Look, it's gold. The Super Zaxxon. But cabinet dedicated with that gorgeous red joystick, but it has a Zaxxon board in it. And why do we have a Zaxxon board in it? You should know.
Because Super Zaxxon is impossible to play.
I like that word, impossible. Impossible.
Impossible.
You're dead in 60 seconds.
Or less. What fun is that?
Or less.
Not any fun.
Now, as you know, your first game of Super Zaxxon, when you first start the first game, after you turn it on,
you die.
The sound does not kick on for a few seconds. And then every game after that, it's fine. I don't know what it is. It's the first game of first setting it on. Is somebody going to get this?
Well, he was holding his pants up.
Kill him. Phone's ringing in the house like this, Gerald. That's good. Do you hear the phone ringing?
Oh. Where's our secretary at? Pam?
Wait, the wife is in the car. She doesn't.
She's camera shy. She doesn't want to be. She's be famous.
She's in the witness protection.
We'll go with that.
Now listen, he's been watching the bargain basement videos. Why haven't you been buying? It's another game gone. We actually have more than 500 into it, but you made out on the trade.
I heard 420 miles.
What? Where do you come from?
Virginia.
Charleston.
You drove from Charleston?
Yeah. 7 hours. For this bargain.
That gold, you mean?
Gold.
I'm impressed. I didn't know you were coming that far.
Should have just shipped it to you.
Well, here's the good news. Power supply's brand new. What was brand new, when, in the summer? Last summer? When did he get it? Like August. About a year ago, a little under a year ago. The monitor's rebuilt with all new capacitors. There was a new fluorescent light in it. And they used it for how many months? About 2 months? Because this was in an earlier bargain basement. You've been watching it.
I've been watching.
Waiting. Now here's the funny thing. Next door, we have a Zaxxon for $400. I got a deposit. It's really rough. Not really rough, but it needs, we haven't done anything to it. I got a deposit. Now the guy, he can't buy it now. So I have a Zaxxon for $400. Oh, it's not as big as this.
No.
You want that instead? No. No, you want the door to go. There's even new casters on the bottom of it. So let's get him loaded up. And oh, he needs me for something. Gerald, thank you for making the trip. You might stay over, I hear.
Maybe.
At your house.
You can eat Daddy Pops in the morning for breakfast.
Sounds good.
I'll tell you what, I'm going to give him some info because we got to get back over here. Gone. He says he wants more. Once he gets that toilet home, I wonder what he'll think. Just kidding. He washes. He's a regular. He knows. I told him I was going to say that. Actually, I didn't.
Kurt, are you going to rub the whole time I'm on this video?
Yep.
We sold another game, as is, a Star Wars by Data East. Now, this Star Wars we had sold 14 years ago or something, so it was in great shape, but it needed to be re-rubbered, LED, but the guy got a great deal. We have all the stuff we'll sell as is, but electronically perfect, on our website. So if you go on our pinball or video game inventory, you can see. Let's cut to that. One of our regular customers is buying our Star Wars that we sold back in 2000. Electronically, it's done. As a matter of fact, we went over all the boards again. We put in a button battery. All the solder's been checked. Everything's been done. The cabinet is detailed as it was back in 2000. The cabinet's still pretty nice. But once again, it's not a complete shop out because we're selling it as it is. But I think they'll be very pleased. The cabinets, the playfield's in great shape. It's going to need rubbers, obviously. These are the original rubbers from back then. It's going to need the LED treatment everywhere. But you just play it right out of the box. Exactly where it will be. Loading in the new scores. Got our setting here.
Star approaching.
Yep, one more. There it comes down. Loading in the Mr. Death Star. Kids went nuts for this. There, all automatic. Now, Insta Multi-Ball. Beauty. You know what? This is a really nice job. Full dimensional stereo, too. Anyway, it's ready to get boxed up. Look at our inventory, because frequently we're now selling pinballs shop, but electronically, but as is playfield and cabinet-wise, you can save some money and buy some stuff.
that we can get rid of. We're loaded with pillows. Look around here. James Bond sold as is.
Atlantis is actually an overall equal champions. And so is this one. But here we have close encounters.
Here's one you never seen. They sold thousands and thousands and... No, they didn't. Look, World Cup, that's an as is deal. And look, I'm willing to sell Wallace as is too.
Wallace,
can I get rid of you as is?
Yeah, I'm all burned out.
He's burned out. okay, let's keep going. Pac-Man Mini is coming along. This is going to one of our good collecting friends, Elias. And he's the one that gave us that wonderful coffee that was made by the Mongoose, was it? Frank, do you remember?
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember. It was wonderful. It was that $50 pot of coffee. So we're getting that ready. But guess what? I have a Defender to show you. Great game if you do these things. Look.
Okay.
You got to put this power supply in. And you have to do it in such a way that it's wired in so the guy can change it in 5, 10, 15 years when it goes bad. You have to change this connector with new Triuricon pins that grips the pin three sides and change the pins. See, look back here, see the pins? It's a new black connector you can buy from Marco's Specialties. And then that board will never go bad again. Ha! Thumbs down. There's a tiny chance, but the chances are slim. The lithium battery, that eliminates tons of stuff. Brand new ribbon cables from Arcade Solutions. Is it Arcade Solutions or Arcade? Well, there's the right place. All your troubles are gone. And you know why the board won't fail?
I got his number there, so I'm good.
Well, that's a thrilling...
filming over here!
Robbie, do you think I care? Do you think I could... Every day... You know, some guy called... Now, he's on the turnpike. He's got the top down. He's driving merrily along. And then all of a sudden, he went, TNT! So he calls me, and he says, that Rescue 911 I got from you a year and a half ago. You know, the Wright Brooklyn's weak, and it's been weeks since I got it. And he thought about this while he's tooling down the highway with the top down. I can hardly hear him. Now, why did it just suddenly come to him? Brooklyn's always been weak. It's always been weak.
Plunk.
Are you in front of the gate? No! I'm driving!
He's on his way to work.
It's amazing. Flipper's always been weak. Okay, look. Customer requested the black T-molding, so it looked more like the original. We did put a brand new hard plastic control panel overlay on it. Of course, new buttons. This is the newer release with the black coin door. Most Defenders had that horrible silver coin door on it. Whew, that door was a mess. The black coin door, they got all the bugs out of it. We do have LEDs here. We have a new instruction sticker. A Jeff at Classic Arcades prints them. He requested the cash pan. Okay, and also in the back, you should see it better from the back. We have the directions for setting the game up. Cleverly stapled in there, don't we, Jonathan? We should have shown that earlier.
Ta-da.
Now we're done with that, John. Jonathan said, get these in so I can film it. Now we're gonna go back and I'm gonna show you the game show. Another beautiful game in our bargain basement sale that Joe bought. Let's go. Swords of Fun, almost done. A new customer in Canada. No, it's not Mark. We sell a lot of stuff to Canada now. You know, it's only $475 to ship one game to Canada, and generally about another $150 to $175 for the second to the same address. So it's a great deal, but you will have duty. I think it's 13 or 14%. Pardon?
Make sure you're white.
Frank, that was not even funny.
Well,
I guess it got blended in with all your knee slappers.
Oh, people like my jokes. No, they don't. I just got another thumbs down.
That was me.
Oh, Frank. Kurt's giving me thumbs down now. Guess what? We sold another bargain basement game. Chicago Gaming's famous Vacation Pinball. Let's look at that. Well, looky here, another bargain basement. Vacation America. The famous pinball machine from the movie with Chevy Chase. Oh. But I get a chance to run this footage again. Like that? He didn't?
Another thumbs down.
You know what?
We're in the threshold of hell.
Now, wait a minute. You know what? I'll never forget when I was driving at late at night and I fell asleep at the wheel. See, I used both clips again.
I think that was during the day, though, wasn't it? I don't
know. Kids go nuts for this game. Well, it just so happens everything works well. The game was purchased brand new by the guy we got it in trade from. And I don't know whether he got a divorce or not. This was purchased. It wasn't traded. And it's been sitting, and nobody wanted it. Nobody. Jonathan, it sat on our bargain basement list forever. Until a man bought that, and he bought an ice ball right here. As it is. And I'm going to use the netting for it. This is the one that's still sold new. You can hear me above the fan. Ice ball, because it uses white balls, you can't put dark balls in it, the game won't work. It needs the white balls to sense the optics.
We learned that the hard way.
That's right. So they didn't infringe on skee ball. Clever. Anyway, $2,500, complete working, as is. Everything's there, but working fine. We're $3,000 and we'll clean it up. These are very clean. I have a bunch of them. I have over 150 ice ball machines. No, maybe there's close to 200 of them. Actually, there's one more. And now lastly, I have to share with you this game, this episode had a basement on top of it. He used to be my hero and now he's an imbecile.
He works here now.
Yep, they all come back, don't they? Except Jason.
Jason and Cop Jason.
Cop Jason and Dan.
And Dane and Ryan.
Ryan and they've all left me.
Oh, yeah, real jobs.
Well, I mean, $10 an hour is not nothing to sneeze at. When you get to that point. I mean, this boy's only at $7 an hour.
I work for Rice.
That boy works for Rice. I didn't say that, he did. Listen, this came back. I gotta share with you something really odd about this machine. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna turn this thing off.
It's a good thing we didn't ship it somewhere.
Into it. That's right. We delivered it, it was actually local. Everything was fine. He called us up and he said the two outhole LED bendies were blowing out. Now, what do you say is a bendy? This is a bendy. He said they were falling out. They were so hot. So we took a meter reading, and all of the general illumination was 7.5 volts, not 6.3 or even 6. So we suspected that something was touching somewhere. So the boys went through all the stuff in the plate, all the stuff, went through everything. Couldn't find out what it was. And then they brought it back because they couldn't figure it out. We thought maybe the transformer was wrong. Turn on your light, Jonathan. It turned out that from Mr. Factory, the game was wired to the wrong tap. So the transformer was being told we were putting 100 volts in it. This wire was on the wrong spot. And darn if I know whether it was this one or that one. You see it has three taps on it. You see, in the old days, that's when I was 30. In the old days, you had a little ice cream store or something. You may not have 120 volts. Or to get power to the pinball machine, you ran them through little tiny extension cords or something. So the games wouldn't play. Everything would be a little deadish because by the time the voltage got to the game, it was only like 100 volts. So they put on what they call a high tap. So if you move the tap to the 100 volt setting instead of the 120 volt setting, all the coils would be given a little more juice. And of course, all the light bulbs would too. But the power supply would still be regulated at 5 volts. So it didn't hurt the computer in it, but the light bulbs and coils were all being fed more voltage. And that's precisely what happened. And the only reason it got caught, see, here's the bendy right here. The only reason The only reason we caught it is because the bendy was burning out. So for 37 years, 38 years, or 39, 1979, 38 years, this machine was being, all the light bulbs were being driven at 7.5 volts. And I guess whoever owned it all those years just changed the bulbs when they blew out. And now it's right. Yeah. I should, let me call Gottlieb right now. I'm dialing.
We're sorry. You have reached a number that has been disconnected or is no longer in service. If you feel you have reached this recording error, please check the number and try your call again.
Can't complain, can I? Anyway, boys, this guy is having a stroke. Can you deliver this back to him as soon as possible?
Huh?
We will move on. See, I synced that in perfect, Frank. People would have suspected I was one of the Pointer Sisters. He couldn't think of anything. He's very cross right now, very upset. I have one last funny thing to read you. I got this email, spam email. This is really funny. It was a comment. I wanted to compose you one very smart remark to be able to thank you very much as before relating to the pleasant basics you have documented in this article. It was certainly strangely generous of you to offer freely, precisely, what a number of us could possibly have marketed for an ebook to get some bucks for their own end, mostly seeing that you could have tried it if you ever wanted. Period. Those thoughts additionally worked as a great way to realize that someone else have similar dreams, really like mine, to know the truth somewhat more with regard to this issue. I'm certain there are millions of more fun situations in the future for people who go through your blog. Now, what the heck was that all about? Frank! I have to weed through all this stuff. But I like reading your comments, and so does Frank. We love it when people leave us nice comments. We block those that don't. I hear the music, Frank, from Walt Disney's Atlantis, and that's, we're going to end our video with that. Goodbye.